this video, we're gonna be covering the best hashtag strategies for you to get more views and more followers on Instagram. Because at the end of the day, the organic reach on Instagram is starting to increase, but if you are not posting at the right time, posting the right content, or most importantly, using the right hashtags, it is going to significantly decrease the amount of views and the amount of followers that you're getting from Instagram. And trust me, there is not always organic reach on Instagram. In fact, this is the most organic reach that Instagram has ever had in the last 3 years. So you guys need to pay attention to this and need to make sure that you're implementing these hashtag strategies. Because 99% of you guys are using an outdated hashtag strategy and it's actually killing your views on Instagram. Because right now, if you're using more than 5 Instagram hashtags, you are actually killing the amount of reach that you're getting, and there's a huge change that you need to make. In addition, and probably even more importantly, if you're using irrelevant hashtags, and I'm gonna share with you what all of that means just in a little bit, then it's also killing the amount of reach that you're getting on your Instagram posts, and this is why you're not seeing the organic reach that you see all your competitors getting. Because trust me when I say this, one of the most valuable things that you can actually have happening on Instagram is your video ranking under a very popular hashtag for your niche for two reasons. First, you're gonna get a ton of views, a ton of impressions, a ton of followers, but even more importantly, then Instagram is gonna know who exactly they should be pushing your content to, and it's going to teach you what kind of content your audience actually wants to see. And then once you keep creating that content, it's gonna establish you as one of the top creators in your niche for whatever you're posting about. But if you don't choose the right hashtag strategy and you implement the wrong hashtag strategy and don't make the changes that I'm gonna share with you in this video, because trust me, hashtag strategies have changed when it comes to Instagram, well then you're gonna miss out on all of that reach. You're not gonna get the followers you want, which is probably gonna mean that you're gonna give up on trying to grow on Instagram. So here's what you need to do. First, you need to make a list of 10 to 12 hashtags that are relevant to what you're actually posting about, relevant to what your niche is, and these you need to focus on. You need to make sure that you have them in notes, you have to have them written down, you have to have them somewhere so that you can easily copy and paste some of them, not all of them, because like I said, so many of you guys right now are using 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12 hashtags on videos, and it's actually killing the amount of reach that you're getting. But you also do not want to use the same hashtags over and over and over again, which is why you need to have 10 to 12 different niche specific hashtags. I want some of them to be big, I want some of them to be small, but you need to make sure that you at least have the most popular ones in that list. Secondly, you now need to go to your competitors, go look at what your followers are doing, and see what hashtags they're already following. If you didn't know, if you go under somebody's followers, you can see the hashtags that they follow. You want to go under your most engaged people that follow you, the people that you see over and over and over again, or the most engaged followers that some of your competitors have, and see what hashtags they're following, because this is going to affect how much those hashtags get pushed out to other people. Also, please, if you're not already, you need to go follow every single one of your competitors, see what hashtags they're using. You can use this as hashtag research. Now, 3 ways that you could be doing hashtag research. First, going under your competitors, seeing what hashtags they're using. Secondly, search for a topic on Instagram, and you'll be able to see a ton of different popular hashtags that are used under that topic. And then finally, go under the posts that are made under that topic and see what other hashtags were used on those posts. And that is how you're very easily going to come up with a list of 10 to 12 niche specific hashtags, and then 8 to 10 other hashtags that are always used on those posts in your niche. Now, in just a minute, I'm gonna share with you exactly how many hashtags you should be using in each video. But before I get to that, I did wanna make sure that you're not making the several mistakes that I see so many creators making on Instagram. First, using too many hashtags. Like I said earlier in the video, you never wanna use more than 5 hashtags. I don't care if you're posting something in Reels, I don't care if you're posting IGTV, I don't care if you're posting a video or posting a photo, you do not wanna use more than 5 hashtags. This is killing the amount of reach that you're getting, and it's actually making it incredibly difficult for Instagram to use hashtags to your advantage. If you didn't know how Instagram hashtags work, it's pretty simple. Instagram uses hashtags for 2 reasons. First, to index content so users can very easily be able to search something up and find relevant content to whatever that hashtag was. For example, if they look up hashtag six pack or they look up hashtag healthy meals, they want to be able to show the user stuff that is relevant to what they're actually searching for. So if you're using irrelevant hashtags, Instagram is actually going to punish you because you're not helping them out. And then secondly, they use it to help determine what your actual post is about, which again, if you're using a hashtag six pack, but your post is about eating chocolates, then guess what's gonna happen? They're gonna then push that to an audience that would like to see that content. And when that doesn't happen, it's going to limit the amount of reach that you get on your post. So many creators don't understand this. An Instagram post is different than YouTube. It's different than TikTok. On TikTok, your post gets sent out to the For You page. It gets sent out to random people, and whether or not those people engage with it determine whether or not your post continues to get pushed out. On Instagram, it's a little bit different. Originally, your post gets sent out to just your followers. And ideally, your followers that interact with the hashtags that you have on that post, be it a Reels, be it a, just a photo, whatever the case is, Instagram is going to send that out to users that follow you that they think will interact with that content. Now, those people don't interact with that content, a couple things are gonna happen. One, they're gonna think that you used irrelevant hashtags. Two, the content's not gonna get pushed out to way more people, and ultimately, it's gonna ruin the amount of discoverability that you have. And this brings me to the next mistake that so many creators are making when it comes to Instagram. You guys are using irrelevant hashtags. Like I said, you do not wanna use irrelevant hashtags. Go under what the hashtags are. If the content that's being created under those hashtags has nothing to do with what your post is, do not use that hashtag. It's going to be irrelevant. It's gonna get your content pushed to the wrong audience, and this is gonna kill your discoverability and the organic reach that you're getting. Now, in addition to that, if you go under those hashtags and your posts aren't better than what's being posted under there, you need to reconsider what you're actually posting. So many creators on Instagram do the terrible job of actually determining what their audience wants to see. Instead, they try to do something that's super unique and end up creating content that nobody asks for, nobody wants to see. You guys need to look at what's being created under the hashtags that are relevant in your niche, under what you're trying to post about, and then you need to create better content. Now, you're probably wondering, Rob, what is better content? If it's information, you need to give the information in a more educational way, in a more entertaining way, and ultimately just in a more concise way. Nobody wants to spend 20 minutes watching something on Instagram to find an answer that they could have just gotten in 3 seconds. Also, this is gonna tell you exactly what kind of formats work. Sometimes it's swipe throughs that work really, really well if it's information, or if it's a prank, it's going to be a really small video, a really short video, or a Reels, because right now Reels has a ton of organic reach. Now, if you're enjoying this video and you wanna grow quicker on Instagram, please smash that subscribe button so that you never miss another YouTube video that I upload about how to grow on Instagram, because there are so many more of them coming. Also, I answer every single comment that I got on every single YouTube video and every single DM that I get on Instagram. Shoot me a DM right here. Now, no matter what niche you're in, you need to be using at least 3 to 5 hashtags. Remember, no fewer than that, because if you use fewer hashtags than that, it's gonna be really hard for Instagram to know what your actual post is about, and it's gonna be really difficult for them to find an audience for that content. In addition, people that use no hashtags are really hurting themselves. If you use no hashtags and you get a ton of discoverability on a post, what do you think would have happened if you had hashtags? You would have gotten way more, you could have ranked for a hashtag, and this would have resulted in you getting millions and millions of impressions if it was a popular hashtag. Now, when it comes to those 3 to 5 hashtags, 2 to 3 of them should be those niche specific hashtags, and then 1 to 2 of them should be the broader hashtags that are still relevant to what you're actually posting about. You don't wanna swap this. You don't wanna do 2 to 3 of the broad ones and then 1 to 2 of the niche. Simply keep it to 2 to 3 niche, 1 to 2 broad. This is going to increase the amount of discoverability that you're getting on your posts, the amount of views that you're getting on your Reels, the amount of likes that you're getting on your photos, and the amount of views that you're getting across regular videos and IGTV. Now, the reason I don't want you to only use large hashtags and only use small hashtags is because they each do different things. Large hashtags, if you rank under them, are going to get you a ton of views. In addition to that, they are a much stronger indicator of what your content is actually about and what kind of audience Instagram should be pushing your content to. But the smaller ones have a chance of blowing up. Now, if you see my videos talking about TikTok or other social media platforms, I typically say do not use small hashtags, but on Instagram, you're going to want to. Why? Because hashtags are always getting used. Say you and everybody else in your niche starts using a smaller hashtag, eventually it's going to grow. There's going to be more content under it. And if you had a post that ranked under that, you are only going to make your post live even longer. The problem with Instagram, even though the organic reach is coming back, is that the posts do not live forever. For example, this YouTube video, you might be watching this a year after I posted this, 2 years after I posted this. And on Instagram, on TikTok, on other platforms, that doesn't happen. So you need to make sure that you're leaving these clues behind, like hashtags, so that Instagram can continue to serve your content and continue to resurface your content to make sure you get views way longer than just within the first 24 hours of you uploading. Now, if you're still struggling to get views on Instagram, I strongly suggest you check out my recommendations package at the link in the description. It's gonna allow me to send you exactly what to post, what hashtags to use, what time to post your content. I'm gonna look at your Instagram, I'm gonna critique it, and I'm gonna make sure, in fact, guarantee that you get more views and you get more followers on Instagram. This is the same exact program that Tuvok 12 used to gain over 120,000 followers on Instagram. Devon Rodriguez Art used to gain over 2.9 million followers on Instagram. Joel Magician used to gain over 500,000 followers on Instagram. And so many other creators have gone through, they've gotten the package, they've gotten my recommendations, took those recommendations, and then went on to blow up on Instagram during this golden age of Instagram organic reach. You guys do not want to miss out on blowing up on Instagram right now with this organic reach, because trust me, it has never been this easy to grow on Instagram before, and I want to make sure that you take advantage of it. Now, if that sounded interesting, go to the link in the description, sign up for my recommendations. You're not going to regret it. But if you don't want to do that, that, I strongly suggest you just check out the video that I'm gonna put up on the screen, because it's the video that YouTube thinks you should watch next. And trust me, it's a must watch. It's about the best time for you to be posting on Instagram if you wanna get more views, you wanna get more followers, and you wanna sell more product.